नॉन प्रिमिटिव एसजीएफ, एसजीएफ मीन्स शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट अल्गोरिदम, शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट इज द एसजीएफ। लेट अस टेक द एग्जांपल टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एसजीएफ, नॉन प्रिमिटिव एसजीएफ। प्रिमिटिव एंड नॉन प्रिमिटिव दिस आर द टू टाइप्स ऑफ शॉर्टेज जॉब। फर्स्ट वी विल टेक द फर्स्ट नॉन प्रिमिटिव एसजीएफ। नॉन प्रिमिटिव मीन्स वंस अ प्रोसेस अलोकेट द सीपीयू इट विल not release that processor until it finishes its complete work. Okay, that is a non-primitive. Here is an example is given. Process P1, arrival time is also given 0 and burst time is also given 5. P2, arrival time 1 is given, burst time will be given 4. For process P3, arrival time 2 and CPU burst time is 4. And process P4, arrival time will be 3 and CPU time, that is a 6. Now we have to calculate two terms. We have to calculate average waiting time and average turnaround time. That is a problem we have to find. For that purpose, we have to first create a Gantt chart for the process. Process 1 is a P1. Arrival time 0 means at the 0 time only process P1 will in a ready queue. Okay. And what is the shortage job? Shortage job is P2 and P2 is 4, P3 is 4 and P4 is 6. Which is the shortest? P2 and P3 are equal, 4, 4, but we will take the P2, but it will arrive at the time 1 and P1 will arrive at the time 0. That's why at the 0 time only one process is there in a ready queue, that is the P1. That's why CPU allocate to the which process? Single process that is in a ready queue, P1, regardless of its burst time, because its burst time is 5, but at that time there is a no process to compete with the P1. That's why P1 get the CPU. P1 gets the CPU at the 0 time and it will 0 to 5 continue because it is a non-primitive SGF. Once the CPU get allocated to the P1 process, it will not release until it complete, and it will complete when its burst will end. Its burst is 5. That's why P1 कहाँ तक execute होगी? 0 to 5 तक execute होगी. उसके बाद में processor किसे मिलेगा? Shortest को. Shortest कौन सी है? P2, P3 दोनों भी कितनी है? 4, 4, और P4 कितनी है? 6. शॉर्टेस्ट कौन सी है? दोनों भी सेम ही है, 4, 4. उसमें फर्स्ट कौन सी आई हुई है? P2 आई हुई है. दैट्स वाई देर इज FCFS, फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, SGF. इन दैट FCFS वी हैव टू यूज. दैट्स वाई प्रोसेसर विल अलोकेट टू द P2 प्रोसेस. P2 विल बी 5 to 9 विल बी एग्जीक्यूट. आफ्टर दैट प्रोसेसर विल बी अलोकेट टू द नेक्स्ट शॉर्टेज जॉब, दैट इज अ 4 P3 process, that is a 9 to 13, and after that it will allocate to the process P4, that is 13 to 19. Hence we have prepared the Gantt chart. Now we have to calculate the average waiting time and average turnaround time. From this chart we will understand the waiting time of each process. For waiting time of P1, we see that it will be start from 0, there is no waiting time, and arrival time is 0. We know that the formula of waiting time: arrival time, starting time minus arrival time. Arrival time is given, starting time of P1 is 0, starting time of P2 is 5, starting time of P3 is 9, starting time of P4 is 13, and arrival time is given, we have to minus this time. That's why P1 is equal to 0 minus 0, 0, P2 starting time 5, arrival time 1, 4, P3 starting time 9, arrival time 2, 7, and P4 starting time 13 and starting time 13 and arrival time 3, that is a 10. Now we have to find the average of this to get the average waiting time. Average waiting time is 0 plus 4 plus 7 plus 10 divided by 4, that is 21 divided by 4 is equal to 5.25. In the same fashion, we have to calculate the average turnaround time. But at the time of calculating the turnaround time, we have to take the ending time of the process. Okay, P1 ending time is 5 minus arrival time 0, that is a 5. P2 ending time is 9, P3 ending time is 39, P4 ending time is 19. We have to minus the arrival time from this all ending time, and we get the P1, P2, P3, P4 turnaround time, and we have to calculate the average turnaround time, that is the time.